I'm Jonathan Conder with your updated First Alert video forecast. The weekend is here. It's going to be warm. It's going to be windy. It's going to be humid. You put that all together, we have the ingredients for storms and severe storms. I'm going to spend a lot of time detailing your severe weather forecast, but first things first, if you're an early bird, Saturday morning low temperatures about the lower 60s. South winds during the overnight into Saturday morning, 15 to 25 miles an hour, a little bit more windy for your Saturday. South winds gusting to 35. That's going to warm things up. Highs upper 80s, some lower 90s. This time of year, we expect only the mid 70s. There's some much cooler weather coming for next week. The risk of severe weather for Saturday, the area highlighted in yellow, that's a slight risk. So on the threat scale, goes slight, moderate, then high. Main concern for Saturday, if you live in that highlighted yellow area, that's most of us here, baseball size hail possible, 75 mile per hour winds, a tornado or two is possible. Let's talk about the overall storm impact for you. The biggest impact to everybody, obviously, hail damage, damaging winds. There's a very low flash flooding risk, but the tornado risk is all about where you live. It's somewhere between low and moderate. So let's talk about the tornado risk, the tornado chance scale for western Oklahoma. On a scale of 1 to 10, we have it as a 4, and that's going to be for Woodward, Clinton, and Altus late afternoon and early evening. When it comes to central Oklahoma, the tornado impact is about a 2, so it's a lower chance of a tornado in Oklahoma County, to include Oklahoma City, Edmond, Choctaw, and Luther. So let's talk about the overall timeline for storms. Saturday, it's going to be from 4 p.m. during the overnight up to 7 a.m. Sunday morning. The area highlighted in blue, it's Saturday afternoon into the evening from 4 to 7. We're going to look for isolated storms or discrete storms to fire in that blue highlighted area. That's where those storms could produce baseball-sized hail, wind gusts of 65 miles an hour, and there is a tornado risk. After 7 p.m. to 11 p.m., we'll still have the baseball hail risk. The wind risk comes up to about 75 miles an hour, and there is still a tornado risk. And it's really right after sunset. That's where the tornado risk would be the highest. And from 7 to 11, we're going to look for those isolated or discrete storms to expand to more scattered storms or a couple complexes of storms. During the overnight, Saturday night, 11 p.m. to 7 a.m. Sunday, the severe weather threat comes down. It moves a little bit to the east. This is the area highlighted in that purple color. Golf ball size hail, 65 mile per hour winds. The tornado risk will really come down after 11 p.m. So, what do you need to know about the Saturday storms? Again, most of Saturday is dry, so get out there and enjoy it, but you need to stay severe weather aware into Saturday night. Don't forget to download our KOCO weather apps, whether on the smartphones or the Android platforms. You can sign up for text alerts. Make sure your batteries are in your NOAA weather radios. And what you need to do is look for slight changes. This overall storm system, which is way off in the West Coast, as it gets closer to us, will refine the forecast. Something to think about. We will see some slight changes in the overall evolution of this weekend weather event. But Saturday afternoon, notice that Oklahoma City is dry. It's far western Oklahoma. It's a low chance of storms. Then we get into Saturday night, it's a pretty high chance of storms across north central, central, south central, southwestern Oklahoma. So we're going to look for, again, those storms to start as discrete storms and expand into a complex of storms as they track to the northeast. That's why we have the high chances for storms. Here's Predictor, 5 o'clock Saturday. Notice most of us are dry. Predictor's trying to pop up those storms down your Altus and Clinton by about 8 o'clock. There are a few there. During the overnight, more storms expand. There they are, Oklahoma City, about 4 in the morning. Again, after 11 o'clock, the severe weather threat comes down, but it's still there. Sunday morning, some hit-miss scattered showers and thunderstorms. Then the dry line races through on Sunday. It's east of I-35 from Tulsa to McAllister. By 2 o'clock, we're going to look for storms to move off to the east, and those storms could be severe. The risk on Sunday does not include Oklahoma City, but Tulsa, McAllister under slight risk. There's a moderate risk down in deep southeastern Oklahoma and parts of Arkansas, and there the tornado risk is actually a little bit higher. Here's a look at your complete forecast going into Saturday morning. Clear, breezy, south winds 15-25, low of 62 degrees, 65 by 8 a.m., plenty of sunshine. Remember those winds come up, gusting to 30 by about lunchtime, 80 degrees. The high is 88, some high-level clouds coming in late. Again, a warm, muggy, and windy Saturday afternoon. If you're running the marathon, here's the deal. there's a pretty good chance that you're going to see showers and thunderstorms either before the race when you're lining up or at the start. It's about a 60% chance. Strong south winds, 20 to 30 miles an hour. During the race, we're looking at about a 40% chance of showers and thunderstorms. By the end of the race, the rain chances come down. Temperatures climbing, lower 70s. It will be windy and muggy for the marathon. Remember that. If you don't like the humidity, it will be very, very high. So here's a look at the weekend forecast. 88 Saturday, 80% chance of storms. Again, this is late Saturday night during the overnight into early Sunday morning. The chance that we're going to see storms, let's say by midday Sunday in Oklahoma City, about a 40% chance. The afternoon is dry. Here comes cooler weather on Monday, 73. Low chance of an isolated shower on Tuesday. Cooler yet, 68, then 65 on Wednesday. A warm up by the end of next week, but all of next week, we're going to be clear of severe weather. So some good news, bad news, not much rain showing up for the drought. And you're up to date with the latest First Alert forecast.